Emil Ibrahim, you're back home for the Tobago International Cycle Classic, one day before the start of 27th edition.
I'm feeling pretty good. I went for a ride this morning and my legs are okay, you know. I'm here kind of more on a managerial road as I've retired a couple years ago. I'm still racing and you know, I'm gonna go out there and do my best. You know, I'm not looking to really win. I mean, that would be something that would be really good for me and for the people of Tobago. You know, I'm really coming out here to really help the team and the sponsor, Pharmaco Industries Limited, to try to pull out that victory.
All right, this race was started more or less because of you or your involvement 31 years ago. Looking back from the first edition to now, do you remember anything at all from that first race?
Man, it's all a blur, eh? It's that is a really, really long time ago, and there are some things I remember. We were riding for Kariwak Village. There was a sponsor at the time and a little club that my dad had made up for the race and for Tobago, and we had some other cyclists that was there and competing and stuff. You know, being a little kid growing up, it was always something that you know, I wanted to be professional. I wanted to make it to the best, and you know, I think I pretty much got the job done. You know, for the most part, there were some things that I think that was still kind of left out. Like, I never made it to the Olympics. You know, I never won a world championship medal or anything like that. But you know, it was really hard just growing up in Tobago and being from, you know, a small island, not getting the exposure needed to compete at the world class level. You know, the cyclist this today is a lot more funded with the sport TT and all that stuff, and the government today than in the past. So,
what are some of the highlights for you as you look back 31 years of this event?
Well, I've won the Classic 7 times. My first Classic was won at the age of 18, and you know, it's been a few years since I've actually won the Classic, but I'm not getting younger, and you know, I don't think I can really win it this year per se, but I definitely am trying to help my teammates win.
Where it is now compared to when it started, or let's say your recollection of it, I mean, are you surprised to see the level of where the Classic
is? Well, I'm really, really happy to see that where the Tobago Classic has come. You know, my dad started this race 31 years ago, and he handed it over to my cousin Jeffrey. So we kept it in the family, and it's you know, it's really a great event to see what Jeffrey has done for it, for Tobago, with sport tourism and that, and ESPN, all that, all, you know, we have live feeding this year. So yeah, it's a great honor to have all the Europeans, South Americans, North Americans, just riders from all over the world come here to our little island of Tobago to compete in this beautiful sea, sand and sun cycling event.
Do you set a rule for yourself after you have, well, I don't want to say stop competing, because I think you will ride this until...
Well, I am right now team director. I am also the, you know, one of the co-founders of Pharmaco, Team Pharmaco, Deep South, presented by NGCA. I am the owner of the team in America, and I'm co-founder with Mr. Abood, who both him and I are trying to help develop local cycling in Trinidad and Tobago as well as the Caribbean, and trying to just make that stepping stone for these riders to be able to get the exposure that I didn't have when I was younger, for them to be able to like make that step into the professional league. And you know, we're really trying to also help for Trinidad and Tobago to get more sport tourism, you know, with the team going out there and riding and representing the islands or Trinidad and Tobago.
Thanks, all the best.